everyone, welcome back to my channel. This video is about system of linear congruences. Here, to solve the solution for a system of linear congruences, we need one important theorem, that is Chinese remainder theorem. The statement of Chinese remainder theorem is, let m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mr be pairwise relatively prime numbers such that GCD of mi, mj which is equal to 1 for all I not equal to j. Let a1, a2, a3, etc. up to ar be arbitrary integers, then the system of linear congruences x is congruent to a1 mod m1, x is congruent to a2 mod m2, etc. up to x is congruent to ar mod mr has simultaneous solution which is unique modulo m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mr. So this is a statement of Chinese remainder theorem. With this help of Chinese remainder theorem, we can able to find a solution for a system of linear congruences. Here linear congruence is of the form AX congruent to B mod M. Here the system of linear congruence means this is of the form X congruent to A1 mod M1, X congruent to A2 mod M2, etc. up to X congruent to AR mod MR, where M1, M2, M3, etc. up to MR are pairwise relatively prime numbers. That is, mi, mj is equal to 1. Here relatively prime is nothing but the GCD of any two value is equal to 1. That implies the two numbers are relatively prime with each other. So mi, mj is equal to 1 for all I not equal to j. Here this I is not equal to j. And a1, a2, a3, etc. up to ar are arbitrary integers. In that case, the system of linear congruence is written as like this. It is x is congruent to a1 mod m1, x is congruent to a2 mod m2, etc. up to x is congruent to AR mod MR has, we have to show that it has, that is the system of linear congruence has simultaneous solution which is unique modulo M1, M2, M3, etc. up to MR. Let's see how to prove this statement. Let us prove this theorem. First, let us take M is equal to M1, M2, M3, etc. up to MR. So, first you have to take the condition as M1, M2, M3, etc. up to MR as some small letter M. Then, for K is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. up to MR, we have to take capital MK as M divided by MK. Here we have to take the value as mk is equal to m by small letter mk, which is equal to, here we know that m value contains m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mk minus 1, mk, mk plus 1, etc. up to mr. Here m1 to mr is our m, means it contains m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mk minus 1, mk, mk plus 1, etc. up to mr divided by mk as it is. Here also in the numerator we have mk, here also in the denominator we have mk. We can cancel that term. Therefore, we get mk value as m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mk minus 1. Here mk gets cancelled. Remaining is mk plus 1, etc. up to mr. That means capital mk does not contain small letter mk. In the similar way, if we get capital m1, means that is of the form m by small m1. This is our m divided by m1. So we can cancel m1 and m1. Therefore, capital m1 does not contain small letter m1. In the similar way, we can take m2 as m1, m3, etc. up to mr, and this continues. Here m1 does not contain small letter m1, m2 does not contain small letter m2, m3 does not contain small letter m3, and so on. Since m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mr are relatively prime, it is given in the statement m1, m2, etc. mr are relatively prime. So we can take this as capital M1 and small M1 is relatively prime. Also capital M2 and small M2 is also a relatively prime number, etc. up to capital MR, comma small letter MR are relatively prime. That is, the GCD of capital MR, comma small letter MR is 1. The GCD of capital M1, comma small letter m1 is 1. GCD of capital M2, comma small letter m2 value is 1. This is because since m1, m2, m3, etc. are relatively prime, here m1 does not contain small letter m1, m2 does not contain small letter m1. Therefore, we can take this as capital m1 and small letter m1 are relatively prime to each other. That is, the GCD value is 1. Similarly, capital m2 and small letter m2 value is also 1, etc. up to the value, the GCD of mr, comma small letter mr value is also equal to 1. Hence, we can can conclude in general, capital MK, comma small letter MK value is equal to 1. Yeah, this value is also for K. So we can conclude that the GCD of capital MK, comma small letter MK value is also equal to 1. Also, we have studied in a previous video about the note on linear congruences. If A and M are relatively prime, that is the GCD of A, comma M is equal to 1, then the linear congruences AX congruent to B mod M has unique solution. This is already discussed in a previous video. If A and M are relatively prime, that is the GCD of A, comma M is equal to 1, then we can conclude that the linear congruences AX congruent to B mod M has unique solution. That means only one solution. In the similar way, here capital MK and small letter MK are relatively prime. This is because the GCD of capital MK and small letter MK value is 1. Then we can consider a linear congruence capital MKX congruent to 1 mod M. KX has unique solution. By the note, by the previous video, we studied if A and M are relatively prime, that is GCD of A, M is equal to 1, then we can conclude that the linear congruence AX congruent to B mod M has unique solution. In the similar way, here capital MK and small letter MK GCD value is 1, therefore we can conclude that the linear congruence MKX congruent to 1 mod MK has unique solution. This is one part is completed. Call this as equation number 1. Once we conclude that capital MKX is congruent to 1 mod M has unique solution, we have to find the integer value. For that, we have to construct an integer value as, here we have to construct an integer value as x bar is equal to a1 m1 x1 plus a2 m2 x2 plus etc up to ar mr xr. Here in the previous video we have discussed, if we are saying the linear congruence has a solution, means we have to obtain an integer value for that linear congruence. That integer value is nothing but a solution for a given linear congruence. In the similar way, we have shown MKX is congruent to 1 mod M as unique solution. Next step, we have to construct an integer. For that, we are taking x bar as a1 m1 x1 plus a2 m2 x2 plus etc up to ar mr xr. Next step, we have to show that this x bar is the solution of a given system of linear congruence. Here, we are constructing one integer value, that is x bar is this. We have to show that this x bar is the solution of a given system of linear congruence. We know that since small letter mk divides capital mi, which implies mi is congruent to 0 mod mk. This is because we know that capital mi is a value which does not contain small letter mi, but it contains small letter mk. Obviously, mi is divided by mk. Here mk divides mi is nothing but mi is divided by mk. Mi contains small letter mk, which is divided by mk. It implies small letter mk divides capital mi. So by the definition of congruence, this can be written as mi is congruent to 0 mod mk. Here this implies mk divides mi minus 0, that is small letter mk divides mi. We can write it this as capital mi is congruent to 0 mod mk. We have the integer x bar is equal to a1 m1 x1 plus a2 m2 x2 plus etc up to ar mr xr. So here we get a congruence value as mi is congruent to 0 mod mk. Therefore we get m1 is congruent to 0 mod m1, m2 is congruent to 0 mod m2, here mr is congruent to 0 mod mr. So we get a remaining value as, which is congruent to ak mk xk mod mk. Here mi is nothing but I is equal to i1 i2 i3 etc up to r, but not for the value of k. Therefore we get a remaining value as, here x bar is congruent to ak mk xk mod mk. So we can take x bar is congruent to ak into mk xk mod small letter mk. Call this as equation number 2. Here equation 1 is capital mkx is congruent to 1 mod mk. So this is congruency hold for x. Similarly, xk also satisfies equation 1. Here x satisfies equation 1. We can write it as mkx is congruent to 1 mod mk. Also here xk is also satisfies equation 1. In that case, we can write equation 1 as mk xk is congruent to 1 mod mk. This is because xk is also satisfies equation 1. Therefore, we can write the congruence as mk xk is congruent to 1 mod mk. Call this as equation number 3. Here in the equation 2, we have x bar is congruent to ak mk xk mod mk. Here equation 3 is mk xk is congruent to 1 mod mk. Here mk xk, here also we have mk xk, here is congruent to 1 mod mk. So from equation 2 and equation 3, we can substitute in the place of mk xk as 1. This is because mk xk is congruent to 1 mod mk. So we get a congruence value as x bar is congruent to ak into 1 mod mk. Therefore we get x bar is congruent to ak mod mk. So we construct an integer x bar as a1 m1 x1 plus a2 m2 x2 plus etc up to ar mr xr. Then we show that x bar is a solution of a given system of linear congruence as x bar is congruent to ak mod mk. Therefore this is a solution of a system of linear congruence. Here x bar is congruent to ak mod mk, which is a solution for a system of linear congruences. One part is completed. Next, we have to show the uniqueness for this value, that is x bar is congruent to ak mod mk is unique. We have to show the uniqueness property. For that, we have to consider two system of solution, that is, let x1 bar and x2 bar are the solutions of system of equation. In that case, here x bar is a solution of system of equation is nothing but x bar is congruent to ak mod mk. Here we have two system of congruences, that is x1 bar and x2 bar. That is, x1 bar is congruent to ak mod mk and x2 bar is congruent to ak mod mk, because x1 bar and x2 bar are the solution of a system of equation. In that case, this we get two system of equations. Next step, we have to subtract these two system of equation. We get x1 bar minus x2 bar is congruent to ak minus ak is 0 mod mk. Here x1 bar minus x2 bar is congruent to 0 mod mk, which implies this mk divides x1 bar minus x2 bar. Here this condition holds for each value of k. Next, we are given in the statement mi and mj are relatively prime for all I not equal to j. Here they are given in a statement that the GCD of mi, mj is equal to 1. That is, mi and mj are relatively prime for all I not equal to j. In that case, we can write mk divides x1 bar minus x2 bar as m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mr divides x1 bar minus x2 bar. This is because the GCD of mi, mj are 1. So, mk divides x1 bar minus x2 bar for each value of k. So, we can take this as m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mr also divides x1 bar minus x2 bar. We already write m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mr as some small letter m. So, we can write this as m divides x1 bar minus x2 bar. Here, m divides x1 bar minus x2 bar is nothing but x1 bar minus x2 bar is congruent to 0 mod m. So, if we take this minus x2 bar to the right hand side, so we get a congruency as x1 bar is congruent to x2 bar under mod m. So, we have given the statement as x1 bar and x2 bar are the solution of system of equation, and we proved this x1 bar and x2 bar are equal, that is congruent. So we can conclude that the solution is unique. So x bar is the solution of system of equation. This is the uniqueness of a system of equation. Hence, we proved the theorem, that is, the system of linear congruence has simultaneous solution which is unique under modulo m. Hence, we proved the theorem. This is about Chinese remainder theorem. Next, we shall see what are all the working rules to solve or to obtain the solution of system of linear congruences. Here, they will give a system of linear congruences in the form x is congruent to a1 mod m1, x is congruent to a2 mod m2, etc. up to x is congruent to ar mod mr. In that case, to obtain the solution of system of linear congruences, here, what's the first step? First step is to verify that the GCD of mi, mj is equal to 1 for all I not equal to j. Here, they will give m1, m2, etc. up to mr. For this m1 to mr, here we are used to find the GCD for all the value of I and j. For all I not equal to j, that must be equal to 1. That is, mi and mj must be relatively prime. We have to verify mi and mj must be relatively prime or not. That's the first step. After verifying relatively prime, second step, you have to take this m1, m2, etc. up to mr as some m. So, the product of m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mr is some small letter m. That's the second step. Next step, you have to find capital mk. We know that capital mk is m divided by small letter mk. That is, small m divided by small letter mk for all k is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. up to r. They will give 1, 2, 3, etc. up to r. So, for all value of k, we have to find mk. That is, m1, m2, m3, etc. up to mr, we have to find the value. Next step, we have to consider consider the linear congruence in the form mkx congruent to 1 mod mk. After finding m value, mk value, you have to consider a linear congruence as mkx congruent to 1 mod mk, and we have to satisfy with the unique solution of xk. Here we have to find the x value. By the inspection method, we have to find the x value and we have to satisfy with a unique solution. That's the fourth step. Finally, the unique solution of system of linear congruence is given by, here after obtaining x value, m value, mk value, and already we know a1, a2, etc. up to ar value, we have to substitute in the formula, that is x is congruent to a1 m1 x1 plus a2 m2 x2 plus etc. up to ar mr xr under mod m. So this is a formula to find the unique solution of system of linear congruences. So these are all the working procedure to find the solution for an system of linear congruences. We shall solve some of the problems on finding the solution of system of congruences. Here is the first problem. Solve the system of linear congruences. X is congruent to 2 mod 3, x is congruent to 3 mod 5, x is congruent to 2 mod 7. Here they have given 3 system of linear congruence in the form x is congruent to a1 mod m1, x is congruent to a2 mod m2, and x is congruent to a3 mod m3. So first step, we have to take a1, a2, a3 value and m1, m2, m3 value. So a1 is 2, a2 is 3 and a3 is 2 here. Similarly, m1 is 3, m2 is 5 and m3 is 7. Next step, first we have to verify the condition, that is the GCD of mi, mj is equal to 1 for all I not equal to j, the time not equal to j. For that we have to find the GCD. Here we have given m1, m2, m3 value, so we have to verify that m1, m2 is equal to 1, m2, m3 is equal to 1 and m1 and m3 equal to 1. That is GCD of m1, m2, m3 are relatively prime. So we have taken here 3, 5, we have to verify that 3, 5 GCD is 1 and 5, 7 GCD is 1. Similarly, 3 and 7 GCD is 1. In the previous videos, we studied how to find the GCD for bigger value. For this smaller value, it is very easy to find the GCD in this form. Here I have taken for this value, that is the GCD of 3 and 5. Here the GCD of 3 and 5 is nothing but we have to find the greatest common divisor for 3 and 5. We know that for 3, the divisors of 3 is, here the 3 is divided by the value 1 and 3. Here 3 is divided by 1 and 3 itself. So the divisors of 3, we can take this as 1 and 3. We can call this definition as 3 is a prime number, because prime, the definition of prime number says the number which is divided by 1 and the number itself is nothing but a prime number. So the divisors of 3 is 1 and the 3 itself. So we can call 3 as a prime number. So for the prime number, the divisors are the number 1 and the number itself. So similarly, for the divisors of 5 is, here 5 is the value they have given for, so we have to find the divisor for 5. That means the divisor of 5 is 1 and 5 itself. Here 1 divides 5 and 5 divides 5. So we can take this as 5 is a prime number. Also we know that 5 is a prime number because 5 is divided by the number 1 and actual number itself. So the divisors of 3 is 1 and 3 and divisors of 5 is 1 and 5. So among these two, we have to find the greatest common divisor. Means here 1 and 3, here we have 1 and 5. Here in these two, the common divisor is 1. That is, the greatest common divisor of 3, 5 is equal to 1. We can easily find the greatest common divisor using this method. Similarly, for 5 and 7, here the divisors of 7 is 1 and 7. In these two, the greatest common divisor is 1. Therefore, we can take this as GCD of 5 and 7 as 1. In the similar way, we have to verify the GCD of 3 and 7 is 1 or not. After verifying the GCD, next step, we have to find the product of M1, M2, M3. Here we have 3 congruences, so we have to take M1, M2, M3. So we have to take the product of M1, M2, M3 as M, which is equal to, here M1 is 3, M2 is 5 and M3 is 7. So 3 into 5 into 7 is 105. Therefore, we get small letter M as 105. After obtaining M value, next step, we have to find MK value with the formula, that is mk is equal to small m by small mk for k is equal to 1, 2 and 3. So we get capital M1 as m is 105 divided by mk, that is m1 is 3, 105 by 3 is 35. Therefore we get m1 as 35. Similarly, capital M2, which is equal to M is 105 divided by M2 is 5. That is 105 by 5 is equal to 21. That is the value of M2. Similarly, M3 is equal to M is 105 divided by M3 is 7. So 105 by 7 is nothing but 50. After obtaining M1, M2, M3 value, next we have to consider the congruency as MK X congruent to 1 mod MK for K is equal to 1, 2, 3. Here we have K as 1, 2, 3. So we have to consider 3 congruency. That is MK, that is K is equal to 1 means M1 is 35, that is 35x congruent to 1 mod M1 is 3. In the similar way, M2 is 21x congruent to 1 mod M2, small letter M2 is 5. M3, that is M3 is 15x congruent to 1 mod, small letter M3 is 7. So we obtain 3 congruency. Next step, by the inspection method, we have to find x value so that we have to satisfy the unique condition. So by inspection method, if we substitute x value as 1, we have to take first value as 1. If you substitute x value as 1 means 35 into 1 is 35 is congruent to 1 mod 3, that is 3 divides 35 minus 1 is 34. We know that 3 does not divide 34, so we have to take a next value, that is if we substitute x value as 2, that becomes 35 into 2 as 70. 70 is congruent to 1 mod 3, that implies 3 divides 70 minus 1 is 69. Obviously 3 divides 69, hence we can take by inspection method this for this value, that is x1, as that is if we substitute x value as 2, the congruency is satisfied. In the similar way, if we substitute x is equal to 1 means 21 is congruent to 1 mod 5, that is 5 divides 21 minus 1 is 20. Obviously 5 divides 20, therefore x2 is 1 here. For this, if we substitute x value as 1, 15 into 1 is 15 is congruent to 1 mod 7, that is 7 divides 15 minus 1 is 14. Obviously 7 divides 14, therefore by inspection method x1 is 2, x2 is 1 and x3 is 1 are satisfied. After obtaining x1, x2, x3 value, M1, M2, M3 value and A1, A2, A3 value we already known. Finally, the unique solution of system of linear congruence is given by the formula x is congruent to A1, M1, X1 plus A2, M2, X2 plus etc. up to AR, MR, XR under mod M. Here we have K is equal to 1, 2, 3. Therefore, we equation or congruency reduces to x is congruent to A1, M1, X1 plus A2, M2, X2 plus A3, M3, X3 under mod M. We have to substitute all these values. We get x is congruent to A1 is 2 into M1 is 35 into X1 is 2 plus A2 is 3 into M2 is 21 into X2 is 1 plus A3 is 2 plus M3 is 15 into X3 is 1 under mod 105. Here M value is 105, you have to substitute M value. Next step, after simplifying the value, we get as x is congruent to this value becomes 140 plus this value is 63 plus this value is 30 under mod 105. If we add these three value, we get x is congruent to 233 mod 105. But this value is greater value, so we have to reduce to a lesser value. For that, we have to consider like this. Here we have to divide 233 by 105. We get some smaller value, that is smaller remainder. Therefore, we can take, that is 105 into 2. If we take 105 into 2, we get 210. So next step, we have to subtract 233 by 210, we get 23 as a remainder, which is less value. So in the place of 233, we can take it as 23, because 233 is congruent to 23 mod 105. Therefore, we can take this as x is congruent to 23 mod 105 is a unique solution for a given system of linear congruence. This completes the problem. So this is a method to find the solution for a system of linear congruence. We shall move on to another problem so that you can understand in a better way. Solve the system of linear congruences using Chinese remainder theorem for x is congruent to 3 mod 5, x is congruent to 2 mod 6, x is congruent to 4 mod 7. First step, we have to take A1, A2, A3 value, M1, M2, M3 value. Here, by the given data, we can take A1 as 3, A2 is 2 and A3 is 4. Similarly, M1 is 5, M2 is 6 and M3 is 7. Next step, we have to verify that GCD of this 5 and 6 is 1 and 6 and 7 is 1. Similarly, 5 and 7 is 1 or not. For that, we have to verify the GCD using this form. Here, first is that we have to verify the GCD of 5 and 6 is 1. Here, we have to take the divisors of 5 and divisors of 6. Then we have to find the greatest common divisor among these two. Here, divisors of 5 is 1 and 5 itself, because 5 is a prime number. Similarly, the divisors of 6 is 1, 2, 3 and 6. Here, 2 divides 6, 3 divides 6 and obviously 6 divides 6. So, this is not, 6 is not a prime number, but the divisors of 6 is 1, 2, 3 and 6. Here, divisors of 5 is 1 and 5. Among these two, the common divisor is here we have one, so common divisor is one. Only one value, so that is the greatest common divisor for 5 and 6. Therefore, the GCD of 5 and 6 is 1. Similarly, you can verify for 6 and 7 and 5 and 7. So, obviously, these three values are equal to 1. That is, GCD of these three values 1. Next step, we have to take M is equal to M1, M2, M3. So, we have to multiply M1, M2, M3 value. That is 5 into 6 into 7, we get a value as 210. Therefore, we get M value as 210. After obtaining small letter M value, we have to verify that is capital MK, which is equal to M by MK for K is equal to 1, 2, 3. So, substituting K value as 1, 2, 3, we get M1 as M by M1, that is 210. That is M is 210 divided by small letter M1, that is equal to 5. That is 210 divided by 5 is 42. Similar way, capital M2 is equal to 210 divided by small letter M2 is 6. Therefore, we get 210 by 6 is 35. Similarly, capital M3 is 210 divided by small letter M3 is 7. We know that 210 by 7 is 30. So, okay, we obtain capital M1, M2, M3 value. Next, you have to consider a linear congruence as MKX congruent to 1 mod MK for K is equal to 1, 2, 3. So, we get a linear congruence as here M1 is 42. 42X congruent to 1 mod. Here, small letter M1 is 5. Similarly, M2 is 35x congruent to 1 mod small letter M2 is 6. Similarly, capital M3 is 30x congruent to 1 mod small letter M3 is 7. Next step, by inspection, we have to find the x value. That is, by inspection, x1 is equal to 3. Here, if we substitute x is equal to 1, 42 into 1 is 42, is congruent to 1 mod 5. So, 5 divides 42 minus 1 is 41. So, 5 does not divide 41, that the x is equal to 1. Not satisfied, if you substitute x is equal to 2 means we get 42 into 2 is 84, is congruent to 1 mod 5 is 5 divides 84 minus 1 is 83, also 5 does not divide 83. If you substitute x is equal to 3, that is 42 into 3 is 126, is congruent to 1 mod 5, that is 5 divides 126 minus 1 is 125. Obviously 5 divides 125 satisfied, therefore x1 is equal to 3. Here, if you substitute x is equal to 3, the congruence is satisfied. In the similar way, if you substitute x is equal to 1 means 35 is congruent to 1 mod 6, that is 6 divides 35 minus 1 is 34, that is 6 does not divide 34, so it's not satisfied. If we substitute x is equal to 2, 3 and 4 and etc., we get x value is equal to 5. If you substitute x is equal to 5 means 35 into 5 is 175. 175 minus 1 is 174. Obviously, 6 divides 174 satisfied. Similar way, if you substitute x is equal to 4, the congruence is satisfied. Therefore, by inspection method, x1 is 3, x2 is 5 and x3 is 4 here. So, we obtained x1 value, x2 value, x3 value, m1, m2, m3 value and a1, a2, a3 value already known. Therefore, finally, the unique solution of system of linear congruence is given by the formula x is congruent to a1, m1, x1 plus a2, m2, x2 plus etc. up to ar, mr, xr under mod m. So, we have to substitute all the values here. a1 is 3 into m1 is 42 into x1 is 3 plus a2 is 2 into m2 is 35 into x2 is 5 plus a3 is 4 into m3 is 30 into x3 is 4 under mod m value is 210. So, after simplifying these values, we get x is congruent to this value becomes 378 plus this value is 350 plus this value is 480 under mod 210. Finally, we get x is congruent. If we add these three values, we get 1208 mod 210. So, we have to reduce this to a smaller value. So, we have to divide 1208 by 210. So, we get here 210 into 5, we get as 1050. So, if you subtract these values, we get a value as 158, which is a lesser value. This is the form. We know that 1208 is congruent to 158 mod 210. So, in the place of 1208, we can substitute as 158. Therefore, we get x is congruent to 158 mod 210 is a unique solution for the given system of linear congruence. This completes the problem. We shall move on to another problem. Solve the system of linear congruence using Chinese remainder theorem for x is congruent to 5 mod 3, x is congruent to 2 mod 5, x is congruent to 1 mod 11. Here also, first we have to take a1, a2, a3 value, m1, m2, m3 value. Here a1 is 5, a2 is 2, a3 is 1. Similarly, m1 is 3, m2 is 5 and m3 is 11. First, you have to verify the GCD of 3 and 5 is 1, the GCD of 5 and 11 is 1, and GCD of 3 and 11 is 1. Using this method, here obviously 3 and 5 GCD is 1, we can check for 5 and 11. Here we have to find the divisor of 5 and divisor of 11. Here divisor of 5 is 1 and 5 because 5 is a prime number. Here similarly the divisor of 11 is 1 and 11 because 11 is also a prime number. So the greatest common divisor among these two is 1. Therefore, the GCD of 5 and 11 is 1. Similar way, 11 and 3 GCD is also 1. After verifying the GCD value, we have to take the product of M1, M2, M3 value as M. So we get M1 is 3, M2 is 5 and M3 is 11. So the product of these three values is 165. That is value of small letter M. Next, we have to find capital MK value, that is M divided by MK. Substituted for K is equal to 1, 2, 3. We get M1 value as M is 165 divided by MK. That is M1 is 3. It is 165 by 3 is 55. Similarly, M2 is 165 divided by M2 is 5. Therefore, we get M2 value is 33. Similarly, M3 is 165 divided by M3 is 11. So, we get 165 by 11 is 50. Therefore, we get M1, M2, M3 value. Next, you have to consider a linear congruence as MKX congruent to 1 mod MK for K is equal to 1, 2 and 3. So, we get first congruence as here M1 is 55x congruent to 1 mod small letter M1 is 3. Similarly, M2 is 33x congruent to 1 mod small letter M2 is 5. Similarly, M3 is 15x congruent to 1 mod small letter M3 is 11. Next, by inspection method, we have to find the x value for this and for this. So we get by inspection x1 is 1 here. If we substitute x is 1, 55 into 1 is 55 is congruent to 1 mod 3. Therefore, we get 3 divides 55 minus 1 is 54. Obviously, 3 divides 54. Similarly, if we substitute x is equal to 1 here, 33 minus 1 is 32. So 5 does not divide 32. If we substitute x is equal to 2 means 33 into 2 is 66. That is 66 minus 1 is 65. Therefore, 5 divides 65 satisfies. So x2 is 2 here. In the similar way, x3 is 3 here. If we substitute x is equal to 1 means 15 minus 1 is 14. 11 does not divide 14. If you substitute x is equal to 2 means 15 into 2 is 30. 30 minus 1 is 29. That is 11 does not divide 29. If you substitute x is equal to 3 means 45 minus 1 is 44. That is 11 divides 44. Satisfied. Therefore, x3 value is 3. Therefore, we obtain x1, x2, x3 value, m1, m2, m3 value and a1, a2, a3 value we already known. Therefore, finally, we have to substitute all the values in the formula, that is the unique solution of system of linear congruence, which is given by x is congruent to a1, m1, x1 plus a2, m2, x2 plus etc. and so on, ar, mr, xr under mod m. So, substituting all these values, we get x is congruent to a1 is 5 into m1 is 55 into x1 is 1 plus a2 is 2 into m2 is 33 into x2 is 2 plus a3 is 1 into a m3 is 15 into x3 is 3 under mod m is equal to 165. So simplifying all these values, we get x is congruent to this value is 275 plus this value is 132 plus this value is 45 under mod 165. So if you add all these values, we get x is congruent to 452 under mod 165. So we get a bigger value. So to reduce this to a lower values, we can take as we have to divide 452 by 165. We get here we know that 165 into 3 is 330, which is close to 452. So if you subtract these two values, we get remaining is 122. So substitute in the place of this as 122 because 452 is congruent to 122 mod 165. Therefore, we can conclude that x is congruent to 122 under mod 165 is a unique solution for a given system of linear congruences. This completes the problem. These are all very easy problems you can solve easily in the examination. We will move on to another problem. Solve the system of linear congruences 4x congruent to 5 mod 9, 2x congruent to 6 mod 20. First, take the given data. In previous problems, they have given the linear congruence in the form x is congruent to a1 mod m1, x is congruent to a2 mod m2, etc. up to x is congruent to ar mod mr. But in this problem, they have given the problem is of the form ax congruent to b mod m. So we have to first reduce this linear congruency to a system of linear congruency form. That is, we have to reduce this to an x is congruent to a1 mod m1, x is congruent to a2 mod m2 form. For that, first take the first congruency, that is 4x congruent to 5 mod 9. We have already discussed in the previous videos, we have to find the solution for this linear congruency. Means, first you have to apply the congruence method here. here 4x congruent to 5 mod 9, by the definition we can write this as 9 divides 4x minus 5, or we can take 4x minus 5 which is equal to 9 into k. This is by the definition of congruency. So take 5 value to the right hand side and this 4 goes to the denominator, we get x value as 9k plus 5 divided by 4. That's the value of x. The next step, you have to substitute k value 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 1 to obtain the integer value of x. So put k is equal to 0. If you substitute k value 0 means 9 into 0 is 0 plus 5 by 4. Therefore, we get x value as 5 by 4. Obviously, 5 by 4 does not belong to an integer. Next, we have to take the k value as 1. If you substitute k value as 1 means 9 plus 5 is 14. 14 divided by 4 is a value of x. That's also a not belongs to integer z. Similarly, substitute k value as 2. We substitute k value as 2 means 9 into 2 is equal to 18 plus 5 is 23 divided by 4, does not belong to an integer z. Similarly, substitute k value as 3. So 9 into 3 is 27 plus 5 is 32 divided by 4. So we get 32 divided by 4, 4 ones are 4 8s are, therefore x value is 8, which belongs to an integer z. Therefore we can conclude that the solution is given by x is congruent to 8 mod 9. For 4x congruent to 5 mod 9, we can take a solution as x is congruent to 8 mod 9. So this reduced n system of linear congruence method form, that is x is congruent to a1 mod m1. In the similar way, we have to find for this value, that is 2x congruent to 6 mod 20. We can write by the definition, we can write this as 20 divides 2x minus 6, or we can take this as 2x minus 6 is equal to 20 into some integer k. So take 6 value to the right hand side and 2 goes to the denominator, we get x value as 20k plus 6 divided by 2. Therefore, if you substitute k value as 0 means 20 into 0 is 0 plus 6 by 2. Therefore, 6 by 2 is 3. Hence, x is equal to 3 belongs to integer z. Therefore, we can take a solution as x is congruent to 3 mod 20. So the congruency 4x congruent to 5 mod 9 reduced to x is congruent to 8 mod 9. Similarly, 2x congruent to 6 mod 20 reduced to x is congruent to 3 mod 20. Therefore, these two are the system of linear congruence. We have to find the solution for these two system of linear congruency. Next, the procedure is same as before problems. Here, that is, here we can take a1 as 8 and a2 as 3 and m1 is 9 and m2 is 20. So procedure is same as before. Next step, we have to verify that the GCD of 9 and 20 is 1. So here we have only two values, so we have to verify that 9 and 20 is 1 or not. Here we have to verify that the GCD of 9 and 20 is 1 or not. Obviously, the GCD of 9 and 20 is 1 because the divisor of 9 is 1, 3 and 9, but the divisor is 1, 2, 5. Here the divisor is 1, 2, 4, 5 and so on, but the common divisor in these two is 1. Therefore, the GCD of 9 and 20 is 1. After verifying the GCD, next we have to take m is equal to m1 into m2. Here m1 is 9 and m2 is 20. If you multiply 9 and 20, we get small letter m values 180. Next, we have to verify that mk is equal to small m by mk for k is equal to 1, 2, because we have two linear congruency. So we can take capital M1 as small letter m is 180 divided by small m1 is 9. 180 by 9 is 20. Similarly, m2 is 180 divided by small letter m2 is 20. Therefore, we get 9. M2 is 9. Next, m1 is 20. M2 is 9. Therefore, next step, we have to consider a linear congruency mkx congruent to 1 mod mk for k is equal to 1 and 2. So, we get mk is 20x congruent to 1 mod m1 is 9. Similarly, m2 is 9x congruent to 1 mod. Here, this m2 value is 20. Next step, by inspection method, you have substituted x values and check the congruency. So by inspection method, x1 is 5 and x2 is 9 here. So we have to substitute x as 1, 2, 3 and check the congruency. Here also, if you substitute x value is 1, 2, 3 and check the congruency, we obtain x1 value is 5. For this congruency, the x value is 5. For this congruency, x value is 9. So after obtaining all the values, you have to take the formula, that is unique solution of system of linear congruence is given by the formula x is congruent to a1 m1 x1 plus a2 m2 x2 plus etc. and so on, ar, mr, xr under mod m. So substituting all the values, we get x is congruent to a1 is 8 into m1 is 20 into x1 is 5 plus a2 is 3 into m2 is 9 into x2 is 9 under mod. Here m is 180. So simplifying the values, we get as x is congruent to this value becomes 800 plus this value is 243 under mod 180. So if you add the values, we get x is congruent to 1043 mod 180. So reduce these values to a lesser value. So we have to divide get 1043 by 180. So we get 180 into 5 as 900, which is close to 1043. So subtract these values, we get the remainder as 143. So in the place of 1043, we have to substitute as 143, because 1043 is congruent to 143 mod 180 satisfies. Therefore, x is congruent to 143 under mod 180 is a unique solution for the given system of linear congruency. So this completes the problem. So these are all some of the question paper problems on finding the solution of system of linear congruences. So in this video, we studied about Chinese remainder theorem, and using that Chinese remainder theorem, we solved some of the problems. In next video, we study about Euler's theorems, Wilson theorem, and Fermat's little theorem. Hope you all understand the video. If you have any doubts regarding the problem, comment below. Thank you.